Our guest today, folks, is Copley Gerdes. Copley is a candidate for city council running in District 1. Copley is focusing on affordable housing, infrastructure to meet the growing population of the city, water management, environment, reducing floods inside of the neighborhoods. And Copley comes from a long family history of basically building up St. Petersburg, Florida. There's no doubt about that. Copley, welcome to TFNN.
Oh, thank you for having me. Excited to be here. Spend some time with you.
There is no doubt, man. And, you know, the bottom line is that, you know, there's no prejudice here, but I can tell you, folks, okay, his family has done a lot of work here. They have. I mean, I don't know your father. I know Rob, okay, and I met him a long time ago. And this is, so what has happened with St. Petersburg, folks, just so you know, okay, there's people like his uncle and his father, okay, that have worked for a long period of time to bring St. Petersburg to the level they're at right now. And, you know, Copley, I saw this happen in Boston, and it does take 30 years, okay? But we're here now. You're running for city council. So tell the folks why they should vote for you.
No, I appreciate it. And, frankly, you made me tear up a little bit just thinking about my dad and my uncle and, frankly, all of my family that's, you know, it's poured their heart out to a city they love, you know, all the way going back to my grandfather and being one of the founding members of Azalea Little League.
Is that right? And that is so cool, man, because I'm telling you, you know, and again, folks, okay, I know what the difference is because I grew up in Boston. I've been in St. Pete for 25 years, and I know how much it takes, but they have done an amazing job, and I am so happy that they finally got to see it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, I listen, I've been super blessed to have family on both sides. You know, I grew up with all of them around me that just have a care and a passion for their neighbor and treating them like family. And this was an opportunity to do that citywide. And that's really why I got excited to do it. You know, I feel like over the last couple of years, there has just been this divisiveness that somehow has gotten into our culture a little bit here in St. Pete, where I think we can all agree that we live in an amazing place, and it's grown up in front of our eyes. You know, if you came from Boston, my college roommate was from Braintree, just outside of Boston,
right.
And so I've been up there quite a bit, and so you know that didn't happen overnight, and we've been able to be a part of this generation that's been able to watch St. Pete grow up. And don't get me wrong, there's a long history and some really great things of St. Pete history. And then there's some things that you wish you could go back and shake the head at of some of the people that made the decisions. But we're here now, and we're in such a good place. And really, it was just the opportunity for me to say, listen, I love this place. I want my 4-year-old daughter and my 2-year-old son to live here and raise their family one day. And we should really just try to continue to grow smart because of this little big town feel we have, this small business entrepreneurial shell that we've grown. And I want to keep it that way. And this was the opportunity to do that. And I just think, because of, you know, being able to learn from my family members before me, my financial background as a financial advisor, my capacity to be able to serve because of being a small business owner, and the knowledge that I've been able to gain of our city and how it works, it was just time. And I'm super excited to go to work for a city that I tell people all the time I owe a lot more to than I've been able to give back so far. And this was just an opportunity to try to catch up on some of that equity.
Well, the cool thing is that you were learning right at the supper table or breakfast table. So there's no doubt about that. Okay, so let's get down to it, right? Let's get down. I mean, I know everyone is talking about affordable housing, and listen, we need it. There's no doubt about that. But I got to talk to you first because your uncle's in charge of all the neighborhoods, right?
Yep.
He's done an amazing job. Everyone's trying to do the best they can. Like, okay, the real question is, though, you know, we get a lot of young kids that are acting up in general. And so let's start there. Let's start safety inside St. Pete. What are we going to do about it?
First and foremost, let me just say, we're going to continue to support our police officers, and they're going to be the number one item on the budget every year. We're going to continue to invest in them to make sure that we continue. Now, I don't know if you know this, but, you know, we have the only police force in the Tampa Bay area that matches the diversity of our city.
Right. No, we got a great force. There's no doubt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. And it's because of that intentionality of making them a priority that we're able to continue to do that. So first and foremost, we've got to continue to support our officers, continue to recruit and develop our officers better than anybody else. That's not going to change.
Right.
After that, I think to get to the root of the problem while supporting our best-in-class police officers, we need to, and I think this is where one of the ways that I can go to work on day one, because of knowing how to work with budgets and things like that, find dollars outside of our police budget to make sure that we're investing in our youth. We're continuing to invest in our rec centers, in our public-private partnerships. I'm a board member of the Police Athletic League. That gives kids an opportunity to have positive experiences with police officers, making sure they know they've got opportunities before they go and make a poor decision. And I think that's where we can get to the root of the problem. But first and foremost, we've got to continue to, like I said, invest in our best-in-class police force, giving them the support. They've got our backs. They've got to know we've got theirs. But then making sure that we're investing in our kids and our families. And that's an and. It's not an or. You don't have to do one or the other. You can do both, and that's what I want to do.
Yes. Now, this is really cool. Talk to me about the aspect of water management, flooding. This is happening, you know, in the whole country, of course. So yep. Talk to me about your ideas about water management, the infrastructure.
Yeah, so most people probably don't know this because they're not, trying to dig into the weeds like I am these days. But, you know, just last week, the city council approved the lift station that's going to make sure that our two biggest plants are connected. So when and if there is a capacity problem, if God forbid we had a hurricane and we needed capacity, because right now we do not, we've got about a normal day today is about 40 million gallons of water. We've got the capacity for 100, so we're doing a good job. But to make sure
that's
that we're
great.
Able to service the entire city, we just approved the lift station and the main to go from northwest to southwest. So we continue, we can trade off. Now we can move water from one place or another. If Shore Acres is having a moon tide, we can move that. So we need to continue to on the plan that we've got so far, right? $2.4 billion over the next 10 years.
Right.
We got to make sure we finish that plan. The second is we've got to continue to work, on our coastlines, making sure we're making smart decisions. But really, you know, and it's kind of a boring answer. We've just got to make sure that we stick to the plan. We fund the plan to make sure our water resources master plan, to make sure that we're catching up for the, frankly, 20, 30, 40 years of, unfortunately, it's neglect that this kind of administration the last 5 or 6 years has caught up to. And we got to make sure we're getting there.
Now, how old are you?
I'm 38 years old.
38. Good. We need some good young blood. Folks, it's votegerdes.com, and Gerdes is G-E-R-D-E-S. Copley, you have a great one, safe one. We appreciate it. We look forward to having you back on again.
Tom, right back to you anytime. We'd love to do it.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.